OSI stands for Open Systems Interconnection, and it's a layered model or framework that describes how network communications take place. It has its origins way back in the 1970s, but even today, it's a conceptual model that helps us understand how network communications work. It's composed of 7 layers. Each layer is responsible for a different aspect of network communications. From the ground up, we start with the physical layer. This is where bits become signals, electrical pulses over copper, light through fiber, or radio waves over the air. It's the signaling that takes place over the hardware, the cables, the antennas, and the network interface cards. Next is the data link layer. This is where MAC addresses, switches, and frames live. It ensures devices on the same network segment can talk to each other reliably. Next, we have the network layer. This is where IPv4 and IPv6 live. This is where routing happens, getting data from one network to another using IP addresses. Above that is the transport layer. This layer is responsible for end-to-end communications between applications running on hosts. Typical protocols used here are TCP and UDP. TCP ensures reliability, while UDP is faster, but connectionless. For modern networks, we don't really look at the session and presentation layers very often, but I'll explain those in a future short, so stay tuned. Finally, we have the application layer. This is the layer on the end device, like the computer or mobile phone, that interacts with network-aware processes, like web browsers, email clients, and social media apps. It includes protocols such as HTTP, IMAP, DHCP, DNS, FTP, and others. When a device communicates, data travels down the stack through encapsulation until it reaches the physical layer. Then on the receiving side, it will go up the stack through decapsulation until only the original data remains. For more telecom and networking, simply explained, simply subscribe.